Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the presentation of the colors by the California Maritime Academy's Strategic Sea Lift Officer Program and the playing of the National Anthem. This will be followed by the invocation given by United States Navy Chaplain Mark Jaramel.
Good afternoon. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, by your omnipotent hand, he has graciously preserved and prospered this great nation through much sacrifice and determination over these past 237 years. Grant that we may be worthy of the high calling and the rich heritage that has been handed down to us from our forefathers, who freely gave their lives to secure our freedom and future. Make us reverent in the use of freedom, and just in the exercise of power, and generous in the protection of weakness. We this afternoon gather as shipmates, family, friends, cadets, and distinguished guests to formally inaugurate into office Admiral Thomas Cropper as the 14th president of the California State University's Maritime Academy. Since the Academy's earliest conception on June 3rd, 1929, your providential hand of blessing and protection has established this great institution of 84 years, providing unique and specialized education in maritime studies, where classroom learning is combined with applied technology, leadership development, and global awareness. Recognized for excellence in the business, engineering, operations, and policy of transportation and related industries of the Pacific Rim and beyond. Father in Heaven, may you continue to guide and strengthen Cal Maritime Academy's focus on quality instruction, research, maritime education, and may this inaugural celebration serve the ideal of freedom and courage and honor and commitment, and to dedicate ourselves anew to those values that we hold so dear. As Admiral Cropper takes the baton of presidential leadership, give him clarity of purpose, strength and wisdom to lead, and a strong measure of your mercy and grace to effectively shepherd the hearts and minds of the cadets and staff. With every passing day, week, and month, continue to equip and establish President Cropper as your emissary and representative that emulates in word and deed the enduring motto, to work or to fight, we are ready. May his administration, along with all who frequent this campus and pass through these hallowed buildings, praise you for the treasured opportunities of lessons learned, satisfaction and leadership modeled, and the promise of an enduring legacy. In closing, grant President Cropper, administrators, staff, and cadets that make up this institution your divine presence, and all their challenges, your counsel and protection, securely blessed by your peace and comfort. And we are indeed grateful for your presence here today and anticipate this treasured time together. In God's most holy name we pray, amen.
Please be seated. Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Gerald Jacobowski, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, and it is my privilege to serve as Master of Ceremonies for this historic event, the inauguration of Rear Admiral Thomas A. Cropper as Cal Maritime's 14th President. I want to begin by introducing the members of the platform party. I would ask each to stand when they are recognized. Please hold your applause until they all have been introduced. Beginning with the first row on my far right, your left, representing the United States Navy is Chaplain Mark Jerome. Representing the California State University Board of Trustees, Trustee Lou Manville. Representing Cal Maritime, we have Chair of the Academic Senate, Captain Stephen Brown. Our Assistant Dean of Students, Mr. James Dalsky. Our Community Service Specialist, Mr. Charles Constantine. And First Class Cadet, Molly McQuiston. Representing the California Maritime Academy Foundation is Mr. Thomas Edwards. Next, we have Dr. Leroy Marishta, President, California State University, East Bay. I'm going to skip a couple of seats and go to Dr. Benjamin Quillian, Executive Vice Chancellor for the California State University. Also representing the California State University Board of Trustees, Trustee J. Lawrence Norton. Representing the California Maritime Academy Alumni Association is Ken Passay. Now moving to the back row, again on my right, your left, we have several representatives from the California Maritime Academy. First, we have Vice President for University Advancement, Beverly Bile. Vice President for Student Affairs, Stephen Creedham. Vice President for Administration and Finance, Kurt Lohite. And our one and only Academic Dean, Dr. Niall Ali. Representing other campuses of the California State University, Dr. Ruben Armignana, President, Sonoma State University. Dr. Joseph I. Castro, President, California State University, Fresno. Representing the Cal Poly Pomona campus is Vice President for Student Affairs, Douglas Freer. Dr. Alexander Gonzalez, President, California State University, Sacramento. Dr. Eduardo M. Ochoa, President, California State University, Monterey Bay. Dr. Mohamed Kayomi, President, San Jose State University. Dr. Richard Rush, President, California State University, Channel Islands. Dr. Joseph F. Shealy, President, California State University, Stanislaus. Dr. Leslie E. Wong, President, San Francisco State University. Dr. Paul J. Zing, President, California State University, Chico. Now, back to the front row. Dr. Timothy White, Chancellor of the California State University. Last but not least, and the reason why we are here today, the final person in the platform party to be introduced is the President of the California Maritime Academy, Rear Admiral Thomas A. Cropper. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for our platform party. Today is a historic moment in the 84-year history of the California Maritime Academy. This is our first presidential inauguration. Although Cal Maritime was founded in 1929, it wasn't until July 1995 that Cal Maritime became the 22nd campus of the California State University. Since then, very significant improvements have been made to the campus. Several new buildings have been added, many facilities modernized, state-of-the-art equipment has enhanced our laboratories, and student enrollment has increased dramatically. It is recognized that Cal Maritime makes a tremendous financial impact on the region and the state, and also on the global maritime industry. I believe today's inauguration is symbolic of the continued trajectory that Cal Maritime has been on since joining the CSU, and of the significant role that Cal Maritime plays in the state. In honor of today's occasion, we will hear greetings from several representatives who will be speaking on behalf of Cal Maritime's various constituencies. We will begin with Lou Monville, representing the California State University Board of Trustees. Lou?
On behalf of the California State University Board of Trustees, I want to welcome all the members of the California State University Maritime Academy community who have joined us here today. I'm honored here to represent the Board of Trustees and my colleague Larry Norton and celebrate such an important milestone for President Cropper and for this fine academy. We are pleased that Admiral Cropper has become a part of the California Maritime Academy family. Presidential inaugurations are a time of promise, a time to look forward, a time to acknowledge this president, this university, and all that they mean to the diverse and vibrant community, as well as the maritime industry. It is indeed a joyous occasion that brings us all here today, and I'm honored to offer President Cropper the Board of Trustees greetings and best wishes for every future success. Good luck, Admiral Cropper.
Next, representing the faculty of the California Maritime Academy, we have Captain Steve Brown, this year's chair of the Academic Senate.
Good afternoon. It's my privilege to address you today on behalf of the faculty of the California Maritime Academy and to offer our congratulations to Admiral Cropper on the occasion of his inauguration as our 14th president. I do enjoy working with Admiral Cropper, and he's doing an excellent job as president, but I do have a complaint. Today he asked me to speak for just 3 minutes, which is an impossibility for any faculty member. Although I regularly only have 3 minutes worth of material, it usually takes me 50 minutes to get through it all. But thank you that I can use some of your time. Thank you. So President Cropper did ask me to do the impossible, but in all fairness, I must say that when he came to campus, the faculty asked him to do something very difficult as well. We asked him to take this great institution of ours, which is rooted in 84 years of tradition and excellence, and to make it even better than it already is. And through his leadership, his energy, his vision for our bright future, he is well on his way to doing just that. People have been saying very nice things about Cal Maritime lately. According to U.S. News College Rankings, we are the number one public college in the Western region, which includes 15 states. And even better than that, U.S. News ranks us as the number one best value college in the West. Probably has something to do with our 90%+ job placement rate within 4 months of graduation into very lucrative careers in the maritime industry. People have also been talking about our international reputation for excellence in academics and scholarship. Our faculty have written many of the standard textbooks used in maritime education, and we conduct cutting-edge research using our world-class simulation center and our excellent training ship, the Golden Bear, and our faculty regularly speak on national and international stages. So we are proud of that reputation, which has been built over the course of the past 8.5 decades, but we know we can do even better than that. And during the past year, under Admiral Cropper's leadership, we've been looking closely at ourselves, at our strengths and our weaknesses, and we've been examining our environment, the current and future needs of the maritime industry, the Bay Area, California, and the nation. And we know that in order to meet those needs and opportunities, we need to grow as an institution. We need to educate more students and offer more academic programs so that we can continue to serve with excellence the ever-changing needs of the industry, the local community, and our nation in the 21st century. We have a lot of work ahead of us, but we are well on our way to achieving that developing vision for our bright future. I've already used my 3 minutes, but before I close, I do want to say thanks. Thank you, Admiral, for your commitment to working closely with the faculty and the shared governance of this university. Thank you also for your efforts to transform the social environment of California Maritime Academy by opening your home to faculty, staff, and students. This has always been a great place to work, but it's starting to feel more like a family. And thank you also, Admiral Cropper, for your commitment to support faculty research on campus. This year, President Cropper worked to establish 2 distinguished professorships, and one of which was generously funded by his own family. And thank you also for your leadership, your energy, and the investment of your life into ours. And lastly, I want to thank all of you for coming this afternoon and celebrating this day with us and supporting us as we embark upon this voyage to the future of Cal Maritime. Thank you.